Is agentic AI technology getting a bit over its skis? I think so. Let's talk about it. So welcome back to AI Insights Innovation, the one channel where we talk about the realities of AI and how to make it work for your enterprise. I'm your host, David Linthicum, author, speaker, B-list geek, and analyst with theCUBE Research. Let's get going. So this is a discussion about how the marketing hype out there that the technology companies are participating in around agentic AI specifically, you know, could be getting over its skis. And this is something that I'm looking at with a lot of curiosity. In other words, we're seeing probably the most hyped technology in a long period of time. I understand that generative AI was also hyped, and also cloud computing and other waves of technologies we've had in the past. But in just a very short period of time, we've gone from 0 to 180 miles an hour in terms of the agentic AI marketing out there. Everybody's, you know, agentic washing their stuff. And there's a lot of hype around the use of this technology, what it is, and how to make it work within the enterprises. The curious thing there is that even though the marketing is raging right now, there doesn't seem to be a lot of enterprise implementations of this stuff. So what does that mean in terms of them getting ahead of the market and the enterprises lagging hugely behind? Probably a gap that I've yet to see in my 30 plus years in this industry. So it's going to be fascinating to see how all this concludes. If there's going to be a, you know, technological hangover that happens, if we're going to hit a wall in terms of our ability to use it, if we can't find the use cases. And we'll talk about each of those aspects here. So agentic AI is being marketed as a revolutionary technology capable of fully autonomous decision making, but the real world implementations are falling vastly short, as I mentioned before. So the tech industry has a tendency to overhype nascent technologies, creating unrealistic expectations that set enterprises up for disappointment. And that's core what I'm seeing going on here, and that's what I think the outcome is going to be. You know, most marketing around agentic AI highlights future potential, such as replacing entire workflows or managing complex operations autonomously without addressing the significant development, ethical, and adoption challenges that are going to be faced today. And so, in other words, if we're going to leverage this technology, we're going to have to spend a great deal of money, we're going to have to train lots of people, and we're also going to have to find valid use cases. And I think that's where the difficulty comes in. I think enterprises are looking around and they understand what agentic does, somewhat. I don't think there's a lot of experts in these organizations yet, but they're not finding a particular use case or business case for the technology. And so, and you know, my years in architecture, I could probably say there may be 5% of the problem domains out there that I think would be would benefit from an agentic AI architecture, and the rest are going to be misguided. In other words, they're going to be over application, over engineering of these particular use cases, and they're not going to result in any sort of ROI. And if you know, look at what the stats are out there, you know, all McKinsey and you know, all of these other organizations are reporting, you know, some pretty bad numbers around return on investment coming out of all AI implementations, and this is going to extend to agentic AI as well. So despite the buzz, there are very few large-scale successful implementations of agentic AI in production. I'm doing a few of them, but they're few and far between. Enterprises are often falling to the allure of theoretical possibilities while overlooking the fact that no robust, scalable real-world infrastructure is available to fully support such applications yet. So in other words, we're just not there yet in where the technology needs to take us. Most functioning AI systems today still require substantial human oversight, particular high-stakes decision-making, which is what fully autonomous agentic AI systems are able to do. And so we're a bit premature in understanding what this technology can do, having the tools we need to build the technology. And I think, again, we're lacking in the number of use cases that are out there. Valid use cases where we're able to return value to the business. And that's very important, because if we're unable to do that, we're going to end up not using that technology. So with over 80% of AI projects failing to meet their objectives, their ROI objectives, agentic AI implementations face, you know, compounded challenges due to the complexity and high risk. In other words, it's going to be very difficult for them to succeed with their first, second, third agentic AI deployment. So companies promoting agentic AI as ready for widespread deployment underplay these issues such as poor data quality, insufficient ROI, logistical hurdles, and scaling and governance frameworks that just aren't there yet. These factors prevent AI systems from achieving the level of autonomy that the hype suggests. In other words, we're not where we need to be in terms of our ability to find value in these things, but the hype is actually pushing us out way ahead of that right now. So in other words, the hype is, you know, 5 years ahead, and the enterprises are still in 2025. And it's going to take a while for the enterprises to catch up. Enterprises always move slower than the technology providers. I don't see them keeping up with any close to what the hype is right now with agentic AI. So second, also an issue would be scalability. The ability to scale agentic AI for enterprise use is largely untested. While the marketing suggests that these systems can seamlessly replace traditional decision-making processes, real-world deployment struggles with interoperability, ethical governance, and resource requirements. So my warning here is that the cloud castles being sold were promises of scalability are really obscured by the lack of practical implementation frameworks or technology that's able to make these things scale. So we may see some of these go into deployment, and they may work in very lightweight systems. But when we try to scale to large transactions where we're doing, you know, thousands of transactions a second, things like that, which many enterprises need to do, we may find that the agentic-based frameworks that we have out there now are going to fall short because they're untested in terms of their scalability. And so also the big elephant in the room is the amount of resources that have to be put toward this. Agentic AI is resource intensive, requiring massive investments in training data, compute resources, and infrastructure. Many enterprises simply don't have the capability or the budget, the money, that the support this technology needs. The technology, current dependency on a very expensive GPU-based models make it inaccessible for most organizations, just too expensive, contrary to the claims of its universal applicability. Now, you always don't have to use GPUs with this. You can use CPUs for many agentic-based deployments, but the tools that I'm seeing out there, they're earmarking these application workloads for GPU-based systems, and that's going to make them very expensive, as much as 5 to 10 times the amount of cost as a traditional CPU-based infrastructure. So also, we need to consider some of the misguided expectations that are being set out there around autonomy. So much of the marketing around agentic AI suggests that they can take over complex decision-making processes autonomously, but most implementations are nowhere near that level of sophistication right now. So we're conflating, assistive capabilities with full autonomy and messaging, creating confusion among the buyers expecting a higher level of functionality than what it currently is. And so if we're promising autonomy, we're looking for technology that can deliver that. In many cases, I'm not seeing the technology out there that's able to deliver on the promise of what agentic is. So the excessive marketing of agentic AI is the next frontier, pressures enterprise leaders to invest in systems that may not be ready or mature or able to provide value back to the business. So vendors and consulting firms prioritize meeting revenue goals, tied to AI tech stakes over guiding clients toward practical incremental solutions. In other words, we're all in the professional space, getting down to the reality that we're not going to build something unless there's a very good use case for that particular piece of technology. And that doesn't seem to be the case right now for the majority of use cases that I'm seeing. So this is one of those things where we have a set of technologies that are able to solve a specific problem. And I don't think there's enough of those problems out there to go around that's going to fund the investment that many of these technology providers are making in agentic AI. And by the way, I'm all for agentic AI. I have, one of the most watched agentic AI courses out on LinkedIn Learning and have been, dealing with it off and on as a concept for many years. I built AI agents in the 80s. But my concern with all this technology is the over-application of technologies where there's not a fit. And that's why architecture comes in. You have to kind of consider the current requirements, where it's going to work, where it's not, and making sure you don't make the wrong decisions. So despite the promises of agentic AI delivering transformative ROI, current projects often face protracted development times and inflated costs due to unrealistic expectations. So I'm arguing that by chasing the hype, enterprises skip smaller tactical AI implementations that could deliver immediate value. So in other words, small language models that are very tactically focused to focus on delivering value around a particular use case. So vendor marketing angles often conflate agentic AI's theoretical potential with the immediate application, resulting in decision makers being caught off guard by unexpected implementation challenges. So the big concern here is that the focus is shifting on agentic-based deployments. There's not enough use cases to go around to justify those deployments, but we're also missing some of the other opportunities that AI is able to provide, the ability to build small language models, very tactical focus on specific use cases, something we can build in 3 months versus 3 years. In other words, not moonshots, using technology that's been available for many years, you know, PyTorch, TensorFlow, you know, those sorts of AI frameworks, and the ability to get to a value state very quickly. And then these smaller tactically focused applications will just be built one right after the other, and therefore building a solutions framework that is going to provide the most value back to the business. Trying to push these solutions toward agentic, or even push these solutions toward a generative-based framework, in many instances may be contraindicated. In the case of agentic AI, the majority of interests by a large degree are not going to be a good fit for agentic. And again, my concern is money being spent on this hype-driven stuff where the reality is going to be much different. And we saw this before. We saw, you know, over buying of cloud-based resources, lifting and shifting. And, you know, now we're doing repatriation, which means we're fixing some of those mistakes that we made, you know, 5-10 years ago. I think we're going to do the same thing with agentic as well. And the reality is we don't have to do it. We can get more pragmatic around the hype or how this stuff is marketed. We can, you know, market it around some sort of an architectural framework or guidance, and also understand the advantages, but many of the limitations of this technology, specifically the cost of it versus the value that it's able to deliver. So let's highlight the disconnect between marketing hype and the actual implementations. That's what this show is all about. While the technology promises revolutionary autonomy, decision-making capabilities, distributed AI capabilities, most use cases fall short of these claims due to scalability, infrastructure issues, data, governance challenges. And so I'm warning everybody right now that I'm not trying to be the designated buzzkill, but don't buy unrealistic promises advocating great value or great degrees of cool stuff delivered through this technology. So again, you know, look at the reality of the thing. Agentic AI may hold tremendous theoretical potential, but currently maturity level demands a much more cautious and measured approach. That's kind of all I'm saying. So I've never seen a time in my career where the hype is so far out ahead of the actual implementation of this technology. So my concern is that many people are going to end up following the hype as they normally do and make a tremendous number of mistakes that there have to be fixed later. You're going to build technical debt. You're going to misalign the technology to the solution. Nothing wrong with agentic AI. It's an architectural pattern. It's been out there for a long period of time, and it certainly has value in a certain narrowly typed patterns that businesses see, but it's not going to be applicable in every problem domain you're going to see out there. And that's my concern. So let me know what you think. That's all I have this week. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and also check out our other assets here at theCUBE and SiliconANGLE. And don't forget to, you know, check out my other YouTube channel, Cloud Computing Insider, as well as my InfoWorld blog, as well as my 150-plus LinkedIn learning courses, including my best-selling one on agentic AI. So until next time, we'll talk later. Cheers.